Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're on the Feather River in Northern California going after Chinook salmon. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television.
Today we're on the Feather River. We're up above Yuba City in the Long Hole. A lot of people know it by its name, the Long Hole. About 10 miles up, we're right behind Live Oak. And late in the year, the upper river is already closed. We don't really finish up down here. Hard fishing, you just fish long, hard days, but we're trolling Brad's KillerFish upstream because there's no current. And we're going through this deep hole, and we're just slowly trolling upstream. Been doing pretty well. Catching some big, the older fish are big, you know, this time of year is the last of the run. So we're gonna be trolling up in some spots, and some spots we're gonna be back trolling. But right now we're using Brad's KillerFish, wrapped with sardine, and just slow trolling upstream. What we're doing is it's late in the year and the water, they drop the water real low. So you need to find deep water. And the river's real shallow right now. We're going over 6-8 inches of water in a lot of places. And so what the fish do, they travel at night this time of year because the water's so low. And then they move into this deep water. Anywhere they can find deep water or structure, you know, 8, 10, 12 feet is fine as long as they have some trees around they can hide in. Otherwise, you gotta find this deep water. 25 feet right here is about the average of this hole. And so the fish are laying in here because they're protected. Now at night, they'll move.
Straight out from you. Beautiful.
Perfect spot for a jig. He's using a beeline laser minnow. Chartreuse and silver's always been our hot color.
Real, you gotta keep it coming. Real. Nice dog. You got him? No, I think it's gone.
Right, with the new ghost thread, you don't have to wrap it like all the old traditional threads. You just wrap it on, a couple wraps on each side. Flip the hook over, do the back side. And instead of tying it like most people do, you go through it, you just cinch it down a couple times, just snap it off. The thread doesn't come off and you're ready to go.
Yeah, we're using the KillerFish 16s. That slow water, you gotta get that wobble. So you can't have a big enough lure these days. I mean, a 25 pounder's mouth's that wide and he'll just come up. A lot of times we can barely see our lure, but the 16, it catches more water, gives it a better wobble, wrapped with a fresh sardine. You have to re-wrap. I mean, we barely made a pass right now, and we're re-wrapping. It's, you want that oil coming off at that fresh wrap on that fish, makes it way better. If you can see, we're also using row. We got one guy on row right now. Later on, we'll all go to row at one time. And Procure, it comes out with a lot of product that we use on our row. Everybody knows we have good bait, and thanks to Procure, they take care of me. They give me all my products, and I use a lot of products in there. Their borax is just unbelievable for the end process. You put a little borax on it and that, and they have a great borax. And all their other stuff that we use in our eggs, which is a lot of it. They have Slamola, they have the krills, they have buddy tuna for just to put a drop on it. So when you want to change your eggs, everybody knows eggs don't always work the same every day, but Procure has so many different scents out that try the crawdad and every different one. The oil I like, you just put a drop on your bait. So you can use each individual container. You just reach back and you grab some threadfin shad or whatever it might be. You never know. A lot of times they like tuna. So, you know, the bloody tuna oil is one of my favorites. You just put a drop on a piece of bait and then you use it.
Oh, he's off. Ah.
All right, what should it be?
Just keep doing what you're doing. Keep doing what you're doing.
We've had two grabs and one takedown on party time. So we might be, we got dragonflies on. We got three dragonflies on party time. So we might be putting another party time in the lineup.
What are those? Speckle belly.
Party time got bit again.
Old party time.
Boom, there he is.
There he is. That a baby. Take your time. Keep reeling, keep reeling. Keep reeling. Nice and easy, just like that. Oh, he came off.
Nope.
Oh my gosh. Son of a monkey.
Justin Wolf is a jinx.
Back to the Feather River in Northern California. I'm Justin Wolf. We're with guide Raith Heryford. He's got the four Buxton brothers out targeting the last of this year's Fall Run Chinook.
Well, what we did is we moved up river to another spot. We had five grabs. We had a couple fish on. It didn't happen. So we don't want to waste too much time in the water. You can't beat up in the low water situations. You can't beat up a spot too much. It's just not gonna produce. They've seen what we had. We got our grabs, our bites, it didn't happen. So you have to change. So now we got a real small pocket. We're just gonna drop in at the shallow water, back our lures in a small pocket. Within 5 minutes, we'll either have a fish or it'll be time to move. If we get a fish, we'll land it, we'll go back in, rewrap and try it again. But now we're gonna really jump to a couple quick small pockets. We're gonna move up to a big hole and go to row. Okay, what happened here is the fish, they were here yesterday and they just moved. And so what normally happens is there's a big hole, a rock dam, and we go up there and we normally finish up there every day or run straight to it. We're gonna fish row. We're gonna go up there, fish row. And on the way back, we'll go back to the plugs and we'll hit the little pockets and little trees again. Because I know there's fish in here, but the row bite, it don't last that long up here. So we're gonna go up there and get on it. And then as we work our way back down river, we'll put the plugs back on and cherry pick all the holes all the way down.
Get your arms ready, boys.
Okay, what we're doing for row fishing today, we got a 7-Eleven Cousins rod. It's been a great rod. I mean, we put them through. We've caught over 1,000 fish this year on these rods. Daiwa reels, we're using the Lexa. This is, I don't know what exactly one. I use this one a lot for striper fishing, but Daiwa reels, P-line, braid, Gamagatsu hooks. We're running 1-aught, 2-aught hooks in here for hovering or hanging bait. This is just basic setup, what you need. You've got a light tip on this. It really helps when you're fighting these bigger fish that you don't bend out the smaller hooks. You need a small wire hook so you can get it in their mouth. You won't hardly feel a bite on these fish. So you drop it down, hit the bottom, you're hanging there and the fish comes up, barely taps it, set that hook. The tip, the lighter tip, it's got flexibility. So when the fish gets close to the boat, you don't pull the little hook out. It's got a little barb on it. So you don't want to pull it out. It's a great setup, common setup, Daiwa, P-line, braid, with the Cousins rod right here. Hey! Hey!
That was...
How'd that one fight, Mark?
He was, I don't think he realized he was coming in at first. And then he went, no.
Well, we're like 1-for-5 now.
This guy's fighting a lot more. Ooh, look at that.
Hey.
Cut that one.
He was supposed to jerk. I seen his pole doink, 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 and he was sitting there. He got Hey, so you guys got it. It's really a light bite, guys.
It was. I didn't feel it at all.
He didn't even feel it. But it's a real light bite. That was a big old buck right there.
Yeah, it was like an albino.
It's just a little tink tink, and you got wham. You got, because you know we're using a shorter leader. We're not using that long of a leader because we're having a hard time feeling the bites.
Yeah.
So, little shorter leader, you'll feel the bite. You got to hit them, but you know that's today though. Yeah. We, you know, it is what it is.
pulling it out.
Yep, let him run. These big fish are gonna fight. Keep on reeling and get it.
Lift them now, lip. Lip. Okay, somebody else get in the corner.
It's a lucky spot.
Look how deep that tail's broke.
Yeah.
You can thank
Pro. He was swallowed it. I was pulling him up by his intestines.
You can thank Procure for that.
Huh?
Thank Procure, because they all their stuff they send me to use, it's, I mean, we get bit as much as anybody. Greggy, come on back in the corner.
I guess I'm done. All right, sir. Sit down.
There you go.
Wow. A little more. There you got him.
Wow.
Woo-hoo. Good job, Brett.
I think Martin caught that one.
How was that one?
I was like, I don't want to say anything because I might be snagged.
Awesome.
Got it, baby.
It is what it is. It
went up on the list,
man. Oh, right on, guys.
For today's fishing, we recommend the Cousins Tributary Series 7 foot 11 10 to 20 pound test line. Daiwa Lexa line counter reels. P-Line XTCV 50 pound braid with 20 pound leader for roe and 40 for killerfish. Kamigatsu octopus round bend bait and treble hooks. And Procure Red Hot Liquid Egg Cure. I hope you're enjoying today's episode from the Feather River, where we're after Chinook salmon, not only with roe, but also Brad's killerfish. Now, killerfish come in three sizes, the 14, 15, and the bigger 16. So how do you know which size plug to use? Well, basically, you're trying to match the plug size to your current speed. In faster water, a smaller plug is going to work better. In slower water, the bigger surface area of the larger plug is going to catch more water and give you more action. But you have to be careful though, because sometimes the current speed can be deceiving. Oftentimes the bottom foot or two of a run is going to have a slower current speed than the middle or upper section of the run. So that's where the salmon like to hold. So you might think it's the time for a smaller lure, when actually you're going to need a bigger lure once you drop that weight down and get your lure down to where the fish are. And in the next run down the river, you might need a smaller lure in a different hole in a different situation. So you really need to have a couple different sizes with you and be ready to fish different size lures to find that perfect speed that's going to draw the strikes. Now, one other thing is I can't recommend enough the Fish Field Ghost Thread. This Ghost Thread, you get over 800 feet in a pack, and it is this premium, and it's really an economical and excellent product. Now let's go back to the Feather River and catch some more salmon. We're on the Feather River, several miles upstream from Yuba City, where we've just pulled into a large hole that's just perfect for hanging roe.
We got some Procure roe. We got little fish pills or puff balls, quickies, whatever you want to call them. And you bring that on around. You got to be real careful, because on the tip of your hook a lot of times, it'll leave a little piece of styrofoam. But what it does, it floats the bait up off the bottom. And really, it helps out. We find that we get a lot more bites with a little puff ball on. Like we said, it floats the bait up off the bottom and it gets it in their face. You want it not dragging on the bottom, you want that up off the bottom. We got a splitter spreader, weight hits the bottom, the roe floats up above it, the fish come up, and you bring it right over their nose and boom, you'll have them on.
Get this out of the water, guys.
Grab that rod out of the water, Greg.
That ain't no snag.
Rod to the right a little. There you go.
Keep reeling.
Reel down, reel down, reel down.
Keep reeling.
Out
of
the right. Lift up.
Got it.
Nice. Hey, baby!
Nice. Oh,
yeah. That's the one that got away. That's a big one.
Pretty.
Right on, Greg. Good
job. Bam, and then a little bit.
What we're going to do is we're going to we're starting to fill the box up. We got, you know, 3-4 fish now. So we're gonna fish here a little longer. We're gonna get a couple more fish, and then we're gonna go down and back to plugging. Getting not the size I want here on the row. We're getting smaller fish, so we'll go to the plugs, fresh wrap sardine on them, and we'll start catching some bigger ones. So we got a lot of fishing left to do. It's been really good here this morning. So yeah, anyways, we're gonna get a few more and then we'll get out of here and go down and show you some neat plug fishing water. It's really good, shallow water, but really effective. Next to you gotta fish snags. It's just like bass or stripers or anything else, the salmon like to hide near the trees too. And so we're gonna target those fish and they'll be bigger fish. Get in, get in, get yours in. Not yet.
Come on, baby.
Get a brother.
Go reel down to that weight right there.
Yeah. Yeah. Woo! Leave!
Yeah.
Oh,
they
got us there. Pretty big.
Nice.
Welcome back to the Feather River. I'm Justin Wolf. The Procure Row has done its job, but now it's time to pick up the killer fish.
Yeah, you got him. Got him, baby.
Okay.
Keep him right out there. Catfish.
Cat, what's that?
Catfish.
Catfish.
Who catches a catfish?
Keep
on the
that
plug.
Catfish. I want it.
Okay.
I'm going to give him to Grandpa.
He said keep him.
No, if you guys want him.
Nah,
I don't want it.
He's a catfish on a plug.
It's not uncommon. We've been catching catfish on our row, not on the plug.
It's
a big one.
Broke the suit.
Thanks, Mark.
Keep reeling. Get up against the side of the boat.
Come on, baby.
Get him.
He's close.
Easy, easy, easy.
Woo-hoo!
Wow.
He's a fish. Big fatty. Look at that boy.
Wow. Give it some wine.
Good job, Greg. Way to go, Greg.
So you get bigger ones on the plug.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, you get a big. It's the best bite there is. It's unreal. Yeah, good job, guys. I mean, we've been fighting through all them bites all day for one of them big ones. There it is.
There it is.
Fish.
Woo-hoo.
That fish came on a Party Time non-rattle. We didn't have a rattle on that one. You know, sometimes it makes a difference, and we've been getting a lot of small grabs today, and that one really took it. So I was explaining to him, you get most of the time bigger fish on these plugs, and so that is the biggest fish of the day so far. We've had 8-10 real good pull downs fish on, and that one finally stuck. So yeah, Party Time K16 killer fish non-rattle.
Get him, Kurt.
I'm reeling mine.
Nice and easy. Just let him go. Let him go. Just hold him just like you're doing.
Beautiful.
Reel. There you go. Now that's a line ripper. No, he's coming at you. Reel. Keep reeling. He's just swimming at you.
Wicked piss ups.
Keep reeling.
Anything. There it goes.
There you go. Keep reeling. See how your tip's coming up? You gotta keep it tight. Reel won't do anything, the rod will. It's coming at you. You gotta reel. Okay, now slow down. Right out here, nice and low now. Quit reeling, let him run. There you go, now reel again.
Whoa!
Oh, yeah. Wow! Beautiful! Woo-hoo-hoo! Wow!
stop him.
Got it.
There he goes over there.
He is.
Yeah.
Nice and easy now.
Almost home.
Here it comes. Lift up slow. Stay up against the side of the boat. Lift. 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 Nice and easy, nice and easy, nice and easy. Now lift, lift, lift up, lift.
Oh, wow.
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 Monster.
I got it.
Bigger fish. Bigger fish on the plugs now.
I guess.
This time of year, we always get big fish.
That's a male, huh?
That's over 30-pound fish right there. That is a big. How about the jumps?
Nice.
Unbelievable.
Jumps are perfect, yeah.
Wow. 30 shit. Pound fish right there.
Holy moly.
Get a, this way.
Come on.
There you go.
Once again, the dragonfly come through. It's a pretty chewed up older lure, but that thing's been red hot. KF-16. Dragonfly, boy, bent the hook pretty good. We'll get her straightened out, but unbelievable. Big fish, come on these, right here. Something about the green and the, down the sides and that. They're just tearing this lure up, and have been for the last 3 years, so.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.